Hey everyone, so I am here live in Paris. I thought I would share this amazing view with you. We did something a little bit different. We normally stay in a hotel and I did not realize that this is Fashion Week in Paris. We need to get two rooms when we travel, and so I couldn't find two adjoining rooms. So I found a flat. We rented a flat and it turned out to be such a blessing because look at this view. It's a penthouse and it was like half of the cost. It was amazing. I mean, I actually recommend trying this, but just make sure you do your homework because I'm trying to see. Can you see the Eiffel Tower behind me? I don't know if you guys can see that, but the Eiffel Tower is behind me. It's this amazing, really cute little place. We're like living like in this, we're staying in this amazing neighborhood with locals. We're going to the Boulangerie. It's fabulous. It's been so much fun. It's in walking distance to everything. At night, the Eiffel Tower lights up and we have tea up here. It's just so much fun. So I thought I would share with you a few things, and I'm probably going to babble and ramble. I'm on opposite time zones with you, and we've been up since early in the morning every day, and I'm in my robe because I have pajamas on and it is freezing up here. It's very fall here, but so much fun. So I've got a robe on to try and keep warm. So I just thought I would throw a few things out there. So we have been to three countries. Let's see, we went to England, then we went to Greece, and now we are here in Paris. And people ask me all the time, how do you stay healthy when you travel? And the truth is it's more challenging. It's definitely more challenging. So you have to be more flexible. You have to work a little harder at it. I'd say the hardest place to be healthy on this trip was definitely England. It was definitely the most challenging. The way they eat isn't quite how we eat, so it's just harder. But you can do it if you're trying. And the flexibility comes in. Let's see, if you've read our books, you know we normally eat like 95-5. The 95-5 means 95% of the time we eat pretty strictly according to our plan. 5% of the time, we know no one's doing it perfectly. But when we travel, that might drop a little bit, right? So it might be 90-10, it might be 85-15, it just depends on where you're at. But it all averages out to where you're mostly eating healthy all the time. So it was worse in England, right? But then we went to Greece, it's the Mediterranean diet. It was fabulous. It was like fresh fish, fresh vegetables, salads. It was amazing. So we made up for it. We also tried to find a gym. So in the hotels where we were staying in hotels, we had gyms and we used those gyms like regularly. It's the best way to get over jet lag. Make sure you hydrate, sleep as much as you can because you're on a different, you know, schedule, and then work out. So we worked out. But I must say, we have been walking, I think the least amount we have walked is 8 miles in a day, maybe 7.5. Yesterday we walked 12. So we're walking so much. I actually am beginning to understand and appreciate why the French eat croissants every morning. Because these people need carbs. I don't think I've seen an obese French person since I've been here. They walk so freaking much, I'm just astounded. So I'm actually pretty impressed. We have been walking so much, it's been crazy, and I need carbs. All I can say is I need carbs more than I've ever needed them. I normally avoid gluten like the plague. I'm not gonna lie, when I go to Rome, I have to have a piece of, you know, pizza or some homemade pasta. And normally it doesn't affect me quite the same way as it does at home. And I think it's because they ban a lot of the chemicals we use. But I am going to tell you, after having some gluten after a few days, I'm starting to get some of my old little weird things that happen back. So it's a good reminder. So I haven't had a ton, but I've had enough that it reminds me why I cut it out. Because I was starting to enjoy it, I think, a little too much. We went to Angelina's today. Angelina's is very famous. Coco Chanel made it famous. She used to go there every day for the hot chocolate. And I will tell you, at first I was like, how can hot chocolate be that good? Now I understand. It was ridiculous. Just ridiculous. So that was our big give-in for the trip, was Angelina's. So we did do that. Let's see, what are some of these saying? The French are not breathing New York City carbon dioxide. Yes, this is true. Hello from Michigan. Hello, Donald. Yes, you guys are all so awesome. So we are just having this amazing family trip. I thought I would just throw that in. It's not like we don't have any fun. People are always like, well, how can you have any fun? Well, it's not fun for us to not feel good, number one. So we went to Angelina's, we got dessert. We follow the 3-bite rule. So 95-5 when we're at home, most of the time, that's how we live our lives. if we're going to go on vacation, you know, we're going to be a little more flexible, and it's maybe it's 90, 10, 85, 15, whatever it is while we're on vacation. But when we order desserts, it's like a 3-bite rule. You don't need more than that. It was so rich. We just didn't need more than that. And then we had some hot chocolate, but we freaking walked 12 miles yesterday and 8 miles today. So, I mean, come on, we're making up for it. As far as the calories go, as far as how you feel, now we're going to flush that out. We're going to get back on track and then we'll feel fine. We just don't live our lives there. So when people ask us, how do you do it? Be healthy and still have fun. That's how we do it. I just wanted to say hello to you. It's the Eiffel Tower. I don't know if you can see anything else. It's just beautiful here. And I would, just to throw this out there, it's different. If you want to get a flat, it's different than being in a hotel. You know, you can't pick up the phone and get whatever you want whenever you want it if something's not working. You have to plan a little bit better. But I have to say, there's a lot of advantages. So, for example, we have our daughter with us. And when you're in a hotel, you've got two separate rooms and there's no family room, right? So you're kind of separated. When you have a flat, you're in an apartment. You're living sort of like the locals do. And we have this amazing family room with a view of the Eiffel Tower. And we're sitting here, we get together in the evenings, we chat, we're having conversations, we're able to watch movies and cuddle up on the couch. You don't get to do that in hotels quite so easily. So there are a lot of advantages to it besides the fact that it costs less than half. So there's that. And the people have just been amazing. I mean, do your homework, make sure you're getting a good place, but these people have been ridiculously responsive. So every time I reach out to them, within minutes, they respond. So just want to throw that out there. I'm actually fairly impressed. I like having a kitchen with a refrigerator running down to the, you know, local grocery, the grocery store is like steps away. These people shop like every day. I guess they just take little amounts home every day. I guess it's just such a different way of life. So it's pretty cool. I like experiencing how other cultures live as opposed to just going to a hotel and being in a bubble and isolated from it. So it's been so much fun. Oh, and by the way, that's the view my daughter has doing her schoolwork during the day. There is something to say about being homeschooled when there's this culture aspect. So when we were in Greece, she literally was doing homework with the Acropolis in front of her. And here she's doing homework with the Eiffel Tower in front of her. She was doing homework with a castle in front of her in England. And I'm like, you know, there's something kind of cool about doing school and actually having the real thing in front of you and then going to it and experiencing it. So just want to throw that out there. It's been so much fun. Hope you guys have a great, what is it there? It's afternoon. Have a great afternoon, right? Morning. It's morning. It's morning. 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, it's 11. So you guys have a great day. All right, we're going to go have some dinner and go to bed. Bye-bye.